In this video, we're going to go over how to construct a frequency polygon. A frequency polygon is a graph that provides a visual representation of a data frequency distribution. It uses a line that connects the frequencies of the classes at the midpoints of the classes. In a past video, we discussed what a frequency distribution is. Real quick, you have a data set, you break the data down into classes or intervals, you tally up how many data points are in each class, and you write that number down, which is the frequency. Now we want to take the data that we organized and summarized in the frequency distribution table and show or display it in a graph form. So the first thing we're going to do is draw an X and Y axis. For the X axis, I'm going to put this little squiggle in near the beginning of the line, and I'll explain this later in the video. Next, we need to label the zeros, which is going to be where the X and Y axes meet. Now we need to label both of these axes. The Y axis is easy. That's going to be the frequency or the amount of data points in each class. If you look at the table, the largest number in the frequency column is 25 for the fourth class. So knowing this, we can draw this line and mark it as 25 somewhere near the top of where our y-axis ends. Then we're going to mark 20, 15, 10, and 5 on the y-axis. Make these so that they are the same distance from one another, or at least within reason if you're drawing this by hand. The x-axis is going to represent whatever the data is. So let's say this data represents sales. But before we label the x-axis, we need to calculate the class midpoints for each of the classes. The formula for finding a midpoint of a class is the lower class limit plus the upper class limit, and take that result and divide by 2. So for class 1, the lower limit is 126. Add that to the upper limit of 174, and we get 300. Take that and divide by 2, and we get 150 as the midpoint for class 1. Continuing this process for the remaining 6 classes, we get 199, 248, 297, 346, 395, and 444. And you can see the results in this table. Now that we have the class midpoints, we can label the x-axis. This little squiggle here basically means a broken axis, or it lets the viewer know that there are some values kind of scrunched up here. We can start by marking the value of the midpoint of class 1 somewhere to the right of our squiggly line. So 150 right here. Next, we'll mark the midpoint of class 2, to the right of the mark for the midpoint of class 1, let's say right here, and now the midpoint of the third class. When we mark this, we want to mark it so it has the same distance or width, within reason, as the width between the midpoint markings for class 1 and class 2. So right about here. And we would continue this process so all of the midpoints of all the classes have been marked with the same widths between them. Next, we need to plot the points for each of the classes. We're going to use the midpoints as the x-axis or horizontal values, and the frequencies for the y-axis or vertical values. So for class 1, we have a frequency of 5 and a class midpoint of 150. We find this value on the graph where these two values intersect and plot a point there. For class 2, we have a frequency of 5 and a midpoint of 199. Again, mark the point of intersection with a dot. And you would continue this process for the remaining 5 classes. Now that we have all of our points plotted, we'll connect the dots from class 1 to class 2 to class 3 and so on until we have all the points connected. One last thing that we need to do is draw a line back to the x-axis at the beginning and end of the graph. At the beginning of the graph, we're going to pick a point on the x-axis that has the same width as the width between the other markings on the graph. So right about here. And we'll plot a point and connect the line from this point to the first point. At the end of the graph, we'll use the same process. Plot a point on the x-axis that has the same width or distance as between the other markings, and then connect this point to the previous point. And voila, our graph is complete. All right, my friends, hopefully you got something out of this video. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time, I am out of here.